In this Coach Greg update video, let's talk about cadence. It's something that's come up recently in the McMillan Run Team message boards, so I thought I would put together a short video to give you my two cents on the concept of cadence, how important it is to you as a runner, and what you can do about it if you need to change it. So first things first, why this interest in cadence, which really over the last few years has really come to the forefront for a lot of people. There's three kind of reasons. Number one, it was revealed that most pro runners run at around 180 steps per minute, or cadence. It was also suggested that a lower cadence leads to injury, typically from overstriding. And thirdly, now most of our watches collect cadence data. So before, instead of you having to count your number of steps per minute, your watch displays it. So obviously now people can see and know their cadence in an easier way. That makes people more interested in that metric of cadence. Now my two cents is that 180 is not the ultimate number. I think a lot of there's can be this dogmatic that you have to run at 180. I actually find that most runners between 170 and 190 is a really nice sort of range of cadence. And then as you go into full sprinting and going really, really fast, then you'll see 180 to 200 plus. I know I can get up to a little over 200 when I'm sprinting all out at the end of a race. So if your cadence is less than this, if it's outside that range of 170 to 190, I would suggest it's time you should start working on it. And again, your watch can probably tell you what your cadence is, or you could simply count your footfalls, left and right feet, for say 30 seconds and then double it. That would give you your number of steps per minute. See what it comes up to. A lot of times we'll find that runners who are new to the sport and maybe came into the sport through like a marathon charity program, they focused more on endurance and not speed, and oftentimes they'll have a slower cadence, maybe 160, 165. Sometimes you'll have athletes that come into the sport, but they've got a background and maybe they ran in high school or in college, or they played sprinting sports like soccer or basketball, they may have a higher cadence. So everybody's a little bit unique, but you can get your cadence number, and if you find that for most of your running, it's less than 170, I think it'd be a good time for you to start working on it. So first, let's kind of take a step back and say, what is cadence? It is your number of steps per minute, as I have mentioned, and it's also known, we kind of called it when I was in school, stride frequency. And your running speed is your stride frequency, or your cadence, times your stride length. That gives you your running speed. If you increase one or the other, your cadence or your stride length, you simply go faster. Stride frequency is the easiest to change, and that's why you see a lot of coaches helping athletes to begin to work on cadence. It also can address that concern about overstriding and leading to injury, so we don't want to work on stride length because a lot of times athletes will reach out to try to go faster. We prefer them to start by turning their feet over a little bit quicker, working on cadence. It's best to turn that over, as I mentioned, work on leg turnover as opposed to reaching out and going faster. Now, how to improve your cadence? It's super easy. First thing you need to do is download a metronome app onto your phone. There's lots of those available. You download it onto your phone, and then you can set the metronome for a cadence that is slightly faster. I recommend 5 steps per minute, faster than your normal. So if on your watch you see that, oh, I go for my easy run and my cadence is 160, then you'd want to set the metronome to a cadence of 165 beats per minute. That's what you're going to try to mimic in steps per minute. After a warm-up of 10 to 20 minutes of easy running, you want to perform strides, 8 to 10 times 100 meters. So this is only going to last 15 to 20 seconds probably, of using excellent running form and trying to match your footfalls with the beat that is coming from your metronome app. And then you'll want to take a long recovery in between. 45 to 60 seconds of walking or jogging is perfect. You want to be fully recovered before you work on the next stride. We don't want you, it's not a heavy breathing workout. You shouldn't be getting tired during this workout because we want you to maintain excellent form and have a lot of energy for hitting that faster cadence. For most athletes, the speed, because a lot of people want to know pace, it's usually the first few repetitions, first few strides start at around 5K pace, and then you'll naturally get a little bit faster to around your mile race pace. But again, I think that focusing on excellent form and the cadence is more important than how fast you're going, your actual running speed. Just focus on the effort of a fast, quick, light stride, but feeling under control, never straining. Again, no heavy breathing. And you can do this workout basically anytime. You can do it within an easy run. So say you're gonna run for an hour, you could do 10 to 20 minutes of warm up. You do these strides, and then you do the remainder of your run. You can also finish an easy run with these strides. They don't take very much out of you, but the easy runs are a great place to put them. You want to do this, I recommend, 2 times per week for the next 6+ weeks. So just pick and choose what day of the week works best for you, where you don't have anything like a key workout or something like that. Just an easy run where you can really focus on your cadence and insert these stride workouts. And then what is interesting is to begin to monitor your cadence on your normal easy runs where you're not doing the strides, as well as any key workouts, tempo runs, speed workouts, long runs, any of that, and see if you begin to see a spillover of this faster cadence into your stride. It's highly likely that it won't take you too many stride workouts before you start to feel more comfortable running fast. And you may see that that faster cadence, maybe the 165 or 170 from our example of having a runner starting at 160, that may spill over and you start to notice that your cadence is increasing on your easy runs. That's a very, very good sign. Now, one big warning. It may feel weird to run at this faster cadence. You're going to feel like your legs are turning over very fast. You're not as coordinated running that way. And you know, anytime you change any part of your stride, any way that you run, you become inefficient because you're efficient at what you've been doing for a long time. Now you're doing something you're not used to, so it's inefficient and it feels harder than you feel like it should. But just be patient, that'll go away with a few stride workouts as you get more comfortable running with a faster leg turnover. And then, of course, what you will do is you'll begin to increase the metronome every couple of weeks. So as you get more comfortable, so for example, if you started at a cadence of 160, and then you put your metronome at 165, and maybe 2 or 3 stride workouts later, you're feeling like, okay, I feel comfortable at the 165. Then you put the metronome at 170, and you begin to sort of inch your way up so that you get into that range of 170 to 190. If you're starting at 160, I'd recommend you build this all the way up to 180 or 185 as your fastest cadence, and you'll likely then see that your normal running cadence will slide up to around that 170 to 175, but you've got the capability of running at an even higher cadence, which will lead to faster running. Now, if you want a great visual of what it looks like to run these strides with excellent form, I have a video here of Coach Andrew Limoncello, who's Olympian, doing strides. So you can see he's not sprinting all out, but he's definitely going quickly. He's got excellent running form, and he's really focused on a nice light leg turnover, landing under his body, pushing out from behind. He's not overstriding or overreaching, just excellent running form. We can't all look like him, but I think this video, which I will add a link to, really helps you visualize what does great form look like and how can you have a little bit better leg turnover. So my final thoughts are that if your cadence is lower or slower than 170 steps per minute, it's a good thing to start working on increasing that cadence. Give yourself a few months and you will see significant changes in your cadence. It takes only 2 things, patience and commitment. pretty much like everything in running does, and you can get that faster cadence. And what you should find is that on the majority of your runs, you'll be within that 170 to 190. Maybe on your easy runs, you're more 170 to 180. You start to do faster speed workouts, you might be 175 to 185. And then if you're sprinting really fast or doing these strides and you've really got a great cadence that you've built up to, you may be at 190 or even up to 200 plus. But that will definitely lead to significantly faster running. It just takes a little bit of time. But what I have seen is that if you can just make some small changes to your cadence and get faster, that will translate into some breakthrough performances. A lot of times we're just so used to running at a slow, low cadence pace, for those of us who may have a cadence that's below 170. Once you get more comfortable with that lighter stride, you'll then be able to go and perform a lot better. For me, I am typically around 175 to 180 on my normal easy runs. As I do tempo runs and things like that, I might be 175 to 185. When I do speed workouts, more 180 to 190. And then as I mentioned, even getting up to around 200 when I'm sprinting all out at the end of a race. So you can see there's overlapping. It's not a direct correlation with cadence and speed, but typically you want to be in that range of 170 to 190 for the bulk of your training runs. There's more resources available that I've presented on cadence and strides and getting faster and running form. I'll list those here, and then I will link to those below this video as well, so you can check those out. But in closing, get a number, find your number of cadence, get your watch, and find out what your current cadence is. If it's below 170, then maybe start to add these strides in. In fact, we all should be doing it. I certainly love to add strides into my training. And try to make sure we've got a nice, quick cadence, because that's a wonderful way to improve your performance. If you have any questions, of course, let me know. Otherwise, I'll talk to you again real soon.